Hi everyone, welcome to Science Jagat. Today we are going to talk about telomere, telomere replication and telomerase enzyme. So let's see what is telomere. Telomeres are the region of DNA at the end of the linear eukaryotic chromosome that are required for the replication and stability of the chromosome. McClintock recognizes some special features of telomere that if two chromosomes were broken in a cell, it makes sticky end and one end could attach to the other end. However, she observed the attachment of the broken end to the end of an unbroken chromosome, suggesting that the end of the chromosomes have unique features, right? So here is the structure of telomere. Let's see what it is. Here you can see chromosome which is present in the nucleus of the cell. The end region of the chromosome consists of telomere, and this telomere consists of some repetitive nucleotide sequences at each end of the chromosomes. So telomere sequences are conserved throughout the vertebrates and they form a cap-like structure to protect the chromosome from the nuclease's activity and other destabilizing influences to prevent the end of the chromosome from fusing with one another. And we can see that the telomere DNA contains directly tandem repeat, as I told you, which are in the form of, if T and A have the value of X and the G have a value of Y in the subscript. So here the value of X can be in the range of between 1 and 4 and the value of Y can be greater than 1 only. So human telomeres contains the sequence T2, A, G3. So this is how we can find out the sequence from this formula. Like here we can put the value of X and the value of Y and we can find out how many T, A and G nucleotides are present in a repeated sequence. So these repeated sequences are from about 500 to 5000 times. So here are some important telomeric repeated sequences of some organisms. Let's see vertebrates. As we see in human, it is T2A and G3. In nematodes, T2A, G3. Plants like Arabidopsis thaliana, it is T3A and G3. Chlamydomonas, T4A, G3. Fungi, structure of fungi is also given here. And in Saccharomyces cerevisiae, it's T, G from 1 to 3. So in Euglenozoa and Trypanosoma, it's T2A, G3. So what is the structure of telomere in bacteria? See, certain bacteria possesses telomeres in their linear genetic material, which are of two types. First is a hairpin telomere and second one is an invertron telomere. So in a hairpin telomere, as the name suggests, the telomere bends around from the end of one DNA strand to the end of the complementary strand, like this. If this is just the end part of the telomere, this is the telomere, then the strand will bend like this. So it will make a hairpin loop like this. And in invertron telomere, this type of telomere acts to allow an overlap between the ends of the complementary DNA strands. So here the two DNA strands overlap each other to make an invertron. So now let's think about telomere replication. So first question arises is why telomere replication is important. See, the primary difficulty with telomere is the replication of lagging strand. And why is it so? As DNA synthesis requires a RNA template as a primer for DNA replication, this RNA template provides the free 3-OH group, right? And this template is eventually degraded as the replication completed. So a short strand, single stranded region would be left at the end of the chromosome. So this single stranded region would be susceptible to enzymes that degrade single stranded DNA, as there are endonucleases and exonucleases which are already present in the cell, which acts on single stranded DNA and degrade them out. So if there is a region which is left out in the main chromosome, which is single stranded, then these endonuclease and exonuclease activity of enzymes will degrade the single stranded DNA. So to protect these things, the replication of telomere is important, due to this degradation of single stranded region, the length of the chromosome would be shortened after each division. This shortening of the length of the chromosome with each division is called as end replication problem. This is a problem because the DNA, the actual DNA size is being shortened by each and every division. So this is called as end replication problem. Now there is an enzyme called as telomerase, which ensures that the end of the lagging strands are replicated correctly and there should not be any shortening of the chromosome with the proceeding of the DNA division or the cell division, right? So let's see what is the telomerase. Telomerase was first discovered by Elizabeth Blackburn and Carol Grader in 1984. It is actually a reverse transcriptase that synthesizes DNA using an RNA template. So this, unlike other reverse transcriptase, telomerase, also called as terminal transferase, and it is a ribonucleoprotein that adds a species-dependent telomere repeat sequences to the 3' end of telomere. So please remind it that it is a species-dependent telomere repeated sequence which are added with the help of telomerase. That is why it is helpful in the conserved sequence and in different species ensure that the telomere, the repeated sequence in the telomere should be the same, right? So this feature is there in the telomerase. The enzyme itself contains the RNA that serves as its template. That is, telomerase can add new repeated units to the 3' end of the overhanging strand. Now what is this enzyme telomerase? See, you can see the structure here. This is the DNA molecule and this is the end. This is the telomere part of the chromosome. Here is the telomere moiety, which consists of an RNA template acting as a primer for the DNA synthesis or for lengthening of the end of the telomere. Here is a sequence which is complementary to the DNA sequence. The sequence which is complementary is present on the RNA template, and this RNA template is helping in the joining of new nucleotides to the DNA. Okay, so this is the structure of telomerase, the moiety of the telomerase. Telomerase is a DNA polymerase and there is an RNA template which is used as a primer. Okay, so let's see how the replication takes place. Here we are taking an example of tetrahymen protozoa. So the telomere end of tetrahymen protozoa is in the sequence of T2 and G4. This is the sequence of tetrahymen protozoa, which is present here also. This is TTGGG. Now telomeres contains an RNA primer. I have just told you that this is the telomerase and this is an RNA primer which have a complementary sequence which is complementary to the end of the telomere sequence, right? Repeated sequence. Now this telomeres contains an RNA primer that is complementary to the end of the G-rich strand. This is G-rich because there are four G's here, which extends past the C-rich strand, and here it is the C-rich strand on RNA. Now what happened? In the first step, the telomeres with this RNA come and bind with the extended portion of the chromosome. Then the telomere RNA binds to the protruding end of the G-rich strands. This is the step first when this initiation is going on. The second step is elongation, where some nucleotides will be added at the portion of the which is complementary to RNA primer and which is added to the extended portion of the chromosome, or I can say the telomere. Okay, so what happened? The RNA will serve as a template for the addition of nucleotides onto the 3' terminus of the strand in the step 2. Now what will happen? After a segment of the DNA is synthesized in step 3, see, you can see here some portion of the DNA is synthesized here. So after this, the telomere RNA slides to the new end of the strand being elongated. Now the elongation has already completed. Now the RNA primer will shift to more to add some more nucleotides, right? So this step will be called as translocation. This step will be called as translocation, I repeat. So now after translocation, again this area is free to add some complementary nucleotides in the DNA. So here some complementary nucleotides will be added to the DNA. Again the elongation will be done. So after TTG, same sequence you can see here, it's TTG. So some G and TTG is again added. Like this, translocation and elongation will carry on. So the gap in the complementary at the end, what will happen? There would be a gap in the complementary DNA, right? So the gap in the complementary strand is filled by the replication enzymes polymerase alpha primase. So this is the enzyme which will fill out the gap of the complementary strands, and this is how the replication will be done. This figure is taken from Cell Biology CARP book, so you can refer it from there also. And remember, this is an example of tetrahymen protozoa telomere replication, right? Now next, let's see if in case telomerase is not there in the cell, then what will happen? Let's see what will happen with and without telomere. First let's see what is the difference between chromatid, centromere and telomere. Okay, so chromatid is one of the two identical strands of DNA that make up a chromosome. Centromere joins the two chromatids together and is the region which fibers attach to during cell division. This area attaches to the fiber, spindle fiber I'm talking about, and at the time of cell division, right? And on the centromere, kinetochore is present, which helps in the addition of or in the joining of spindle fiber to the centromere. Then is telomere. Telomeres are molecular protective caps of repetitive DNA at the end of the chromosomes. This is the extended part with the repetitive sequence. Now you can see here, if cell does not have telomerase, then what will happen? So without telomerase, telomeres get shorter each time a cell divides, leading to eventual cell death. This may play a role in aging. You can see here, this is the cell which have proper telomere portion. This is the telomere portion, it is completely replicated, right? But if there is no telomeres, it will not save the replication of telomere, and the end part which is not replicated will be degraded with because of the activity of endonucleases and exonucleases. So in the first cell division, when first cell division occurs, some part of telomere will be lost. Then in the second cell division, some more part of the telomere will be lost. So like this, again, as the cell divides, the portion of the telomere will move, will get on shortening, right? So this will happen if there is no telomerase in the cell. Now what will happen if we have telomerase in the cell? Telomerase is an enzyme that builds and maintains telomeres, right? So it prevents and shortening by adding extra pieces of DNA each time a cell divides. As we see in the replication of the telomere, there are some nucleotides have been added at the end of the telomere with the help of RNA primer, which is complementary to the repetitive sequence of the telomere, right? And it is helping in the lengthening of the end portion of the telomere, so that the last sequences, the last 70 to 100 sequences of the telomere will be replicated when the normal replication process will go on, right? So this is the process how telomere replication done, and this is why it is done, right? So if this will happen, if the telomere will get on shortened in each cell division, then it will cause cancer to the cell, because in tumors telomerase is overactive or repairing telomeres and allowing cancer cells to replicate indefinitely. In case if there is no telomere, then shortening of the chromosome will happen, and of course the DNA is not proper, the cell division will be restricted because of the cell cycle, right? And if it somehow skips cell cycle, then it will form a cancerous cell. right? And if there is an overactivity of telomerase, then it will keep on adding nucleotides to the end of the chromosome, to the end of the chromosome or telomere, and this will of course allow repetitive division of the telomere, and the cell will be converted into the cancer cell. So both the things are bad if they are not in the balance, right? So let's see some importance of, what are the importance of telomerase enzyme activity. There are some importance of this activity also. So telomerase activity is retained in germ cells and zygote and somatic cells after few cell division cycles, and do not show such activities after some cycles, right? So because otherwise if they keep on showing such kind of activities, then they would divide indefinitely and lead to cancer. So the telomerase activity should be in control, it should be balanced, it should be at a time, at a single time when a cell division is going on, right? Not more than that. So thus telomeres shrink, causing chromosome shortening to a critical point when the cell ceases to grow and divide. And if there is no telomerase, then of course it have a importance that it adds on the nucleotides to the end of the telomere, and it's help so that the end of the chromosome will not get shrink, or the shortening will not happen. Otherwise the shortening will happen at a critical point when the cell ceases to grow and divide, right? So there is an syndrome that is called as Werner syndrome, and it is an inherited disease that causes patients to age much more rapidly than normal and is characterized by abnormal telomere maintenance. So this is a disease, this is a syndrome I must say, that is called as Werner syndrome. So thank you so much. If you haven't subscribed us yet, then subscribe for more videos, like, share and comment on our video. If you want us to make a video on a particular topic, then do comment in the comment section so that we will see to make some videos on the required topics. And please press the bell button to make it personalized. Thank you so much.